Okay, so what are we gonna talk about?
How we actually met. And that's right.
Yeah. How we met. Okay, see, listen. What had happened was I was on Facebook and somebody was liking my pictures. And I was like, is this guy liking my pictures? So I clicked on his profile. And I like looked at his profile video and he was singing some song. And I was like, this dude has some really, really nice teeth. I saw the video, so I decided to like inbox him. I clicked on his profile after he was liking all my pictures, and I was like, who is this guy liking my pictures? And he had this dope profile video, and he was like singing. He was like,
I pull up.
And I inboxed him. I was like, hey. Okay, yeah, I said, hey.
I checked the messages, and I was like, who is this girl? So I replied back.
And then I said, like, nothing much. What about you, you know?
I thought I was getting catfish.
But he's seen me around campus. He had inboxed me back, and he was like,
I'm good. I'm just puzzled right now.
I was like, how so?
Because it's you. I thought I was getting punked or something.
I ain't nobody.
No.
He was like, nah, you somebody. And I said, how? LOL. I'm just curious. And you said,
because I'm talking to a girl like you.
I gave him a little eyeballs. Like.
All right. So, after that conversation,
I asked him why he was up. And he was just like, I was about to fall asleep. And then I got this message. And I was like, huh? So, basically, I made the move. But I wasn't trying to talk to him. I was just like trying to see who he was, you know, because I'm friendly.
Yeah, she's friendly. What time was that? We got done, whatever, or 2 in the morning.
So it was like the booty call hours.
Yeah. Somebody asked me to help them clean their room.
At 1 o'clock in the morning.
Right, who asked me?
Yeah, man. I was like, can you help me clean my room? And he came over in a heartbeat, like, very consistent. I was like, so I walked outside. And you know, I was like, oh, it's you. I'm sorry, I look really bad right now. Because I didn't want him to come over because I looked a hot mess, but I was trying to look a hot mess on purpose because I didn't want to talk to him.
She said, I don't have any makeup on. I don't care about that. Well, we stayed up 8 hours, right?
Yeah.
Just talking.
We had really deep conversation. I still thought he was weird.
So what she think now, though?
But yeah, we had this long conversation from like 1 in the morning to like 8.
Yeah, because I wanted to, then I wanted to get ready for it. I wanted to go to church or something. Sunday morning.
Yes.
Yes. I asked somebody to wake me up.
I didn't wake him up. So he slept until like 11. Then he got up and left. I don't know what he went to go do. I had texted him later that day and I was like, you're really a nice person. You have such a great personality.
Thank you. You do too.
But you told me I was special.
Yeah, you were special. I'm beautiful too.
I was like, thank you. You know.
Yeah. She was throwing insults at me, calling me Blackie.
So, after that, he came back over and we went and got Moe's.
Campus food.
Took a picture on Snapchat of my food and he was in the background. It was like a black shadow. I still didn't like him. And like, I kept insulting him. I was so mean. I was like, I can't see you turn on the light because he's so chocolatey.
I just can't. Kept coming back at you with compliments.
It was weird. He was so consistent. I was just like, what does he want from me? He had no idea what we was getting ourselves in. Bloop. Came him.
On Martin Luther King Day. That's when she started feeling me then, y'all.
No, I wasn't feeling it yet.
Wait, I was lighter.
Something sparked something, right?
This weirdo leaned over and he kissed me. And I was just like, I just looked at him like, what are you?
She was like, you know this finna change us, right?
Cause I wasn't liking him yet.
After this, she wants some more though.
I don't remember wanting another one during that moment.
Yeah, you did. So she was like, oh my, this is gonna change us. I didn't want to lead to this.
Had some deep conversations with me each night in the same spot. Every time he had a conversation, I ended up crying. He told me how beautiful I was and how I deserved to be, you know, treated like a queen. And he just told me some stuff I ain't never heard before, really.
And I don't just say that just to say that. So it was like, it was a real talk.
I kept staring at him in his eyes and this was like gotta tell you something. I was like, I love you.
And I went like,
he's like, I've been waiting to say that for so long.
I was like, I ain't wanna be no little buster. I love you too.
We weren't even dating at the time when we told each other. But I said it first. He's like, I want you to meet my mom. And I'm like, what? Yo, mom? I'm just thinking like, what do you want me to make up of? I'm like,
right.
And I'm like, so what are you gonna tell her?
And I asked her, Lydia, what you doing and being my girlfriend?
And I just was like, yeah. I said yes, but at first he was gonna tell his mom that I was his girl without even asking me. I wasn't looking for anybody, that's the thing.